Agriculture Minister Alfred Prospere reveals that several issues facing St. Lucia's banana industry have to be addressed to see a resurgence of the St. Lucian banana in the UK market. The minister says various shortcomings in banana production have hindered further penetration into the market.
We had not so good news, but there is still a window of opportunity for us. And as a government, we've taken a decision to conduct a consultancy in the NFTO in terms of the governance structure and whether what are some of the challenges that they are faced with in terms of recommencing export of bananas to St. Lucia, to England, sorry. We also established a banana task force to really take a very close look at the situation of the industry now, where we want to go, where are we, and how we are going to get there, and to really secure that market for our farmers. We know quality and production have been serious issues confronting us in the banana industry, but we must understand this market is very significant for us, because you're talking about between 12,000 to 15,000 boxes a week.
According to the minister, there have been discussions concerning the regional market being a viable export option for bananas. However, international markets like the UK remain key in realizing export volume goals.
There have been talks regarding the regional market. Yes, we would have preferred having the regional market in terms of banana exports, because the quality standards for the region is always a lot less than the UK. But it's important that we maintain the UK market at this time in particular, because this is where the bulk of our fruits go. I am hoping that between now and the end of February, the Banana Task Force will come up with a report, an interim report, that we can share with the UK people the supermarket people in the UK, and they can get a gist on understanding as to what we as a government is putting in place to ensure that we secure the market. But the responsibility also lies on the farmers to produce the quality requirements that the market deserve. And so we're hoping that we can resume banana exports from St. Lucia to the UK in the few weeks to come.
Prospere is confident that banana shipments to the UK can commence in the coming weeks. In the meantime, the government is ready to work with farmers to get them to the required standard of the UK market.
I have been engaging the farmers in terms of stressing on the importance of quality, but we know there are also challenges in terms of the high cost of farm inputs like fertilizer, avoided and so on. And the farmers have not been able to sell since ELSA. So we just got some fertilizers in country last week, and the BPIP is selling the small bag at $60. And I think from what I gathered before, it's going for almost $90. So we have subsidized the fertilizer for the farmers. I wish, you know, we could give it to them at a lot cheaper, but there are cost implications and so on. So we are hoping that we can continue to work with farmers and to ensure that we can place confidence and trust in the supermarket people in the UK. And we are hoping that we can continue this industry by maintaining the supermarket chain in the UK.
The Agriculture Minister reveals that the ministry is currently waiting on the findings of the Banana Task Force to address the gaps in production. For the DBS News World, I am Jason Darius.